This is the bionic leg that can read your mind. When Zach Vauder wants to take a step, he thinks it, and it happens.
There's nothing special about it in the sense that of what I've had to learn. I just get up from a chair and walk.
Vauder lost his leg in a motorcycling accident, but his brain is still sending commands to a leg that isn't there. This prosthetic has electrodes to read signals in his thigh, a computer to process them, and a mechanical leg to execute them. On this monitor is a readout of the signals Zach's leg is getting from his brain when he thinks about moving.
So knee out, put my toes down, toes back up, and leg back in.
Over time, a team of doctors and designers led by Levi Hargrove taught the computer which signals mean what.
We could figure out using our pattern recognition if he was trying to move his ankle. So knee, ankle, doesn't matter. We learn the pattern and then tell the bionic leg how to move.
The result?
I'm going to extend my leg and point my toes down. With this leg, it brings me right back to basically, in terms of interacting with stairs, right back to not having an amputation.
To prove it, Vauder climbed the stairs of one of the tallest buildings in America, the Willis Tower in Chicago. It is kind of noisy, and it's not flawless.
Oops.
But the designers say they are working on improvements, maybe even the ability to run. In 3 to 5 years, doctors hope to make these legs available to patients, including over 1,000 amputees from the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan.
The wounded warriors, they've given so much, and anything we can do to help them do a little bit better or a lot better, that's what we're trying to do.
But for now, the bionic leg is still in the lab, in the test phase.
You know, I would love to take it home sometime.
The U.S. military is supporting the project with an $8 million grant. The goal? For amputees to be able to participate as fully in life as possible, maybe even return to active service.